In this workflow, we used the famous Iris dataset and built a simple feed-forward neural network with one hidden layer to classify the three iris types. This is a multinomial classification task. Let's start the example with the data preprocessing. First, let's encode the target column. This means converting categories to numbers. For example, one would encode the class column into three columns. Next, we partition the data to the training, validation, and test set. Finally, we perform feature preprocessing according to the data and network type. We deal with the simplest case, numerical features fed into the feed-forward neural network. We normalize the features to the range from 0 to 1. Next, we define the network architecture. We start with the Keras input layer node. This node configures the input layer of the network, which is in fact an input tensor. We need to define the shape of the input tensor based on our training data. In our example, we have four numeric features, therefore we set the input shape to 4 units. Notice that the input shape is the only shape we need to define. The shapes on all the other layers are calculated automatically based on the number of units and layer specifications. Next, we add one hidden layer using the Keras dense layer node. This dense layer connects each unit of its input with its output units. In our example, we set the number of units to 8 and select the ReLU activation function. Finally, we complete the network with another Keras dense layer node. This node defines the output layer of the network according to the output tensor. In our example, we have three classes to predict, therefore, we set the output shape to 3. The activation function we need to use for the multinomial classification is the softmax. It defines the probability of each class. Our feed-forward neural network architecture is now ready. It has three layers with 4, 8, and 3 units in each layer. Now that the data are in the correct format and the network architecture is defined, let's move to the training. We use the Keras network learner node that defines the training parameters and trains the network. The node has three input ports: a model port for the defined network, data port for the training data, and an optional port for the validation data sample. Let's configure the node. In the tab Input Data, we select the four features. The conversion setting will transform the features into a format that is accepted by the network. Our features are of type double, therefore we select the option from number double. Next, in the tab Target Data, we select the target columns. The number of the target columns is the same as the output shape of the network, in our case 3, 1 for the probability of each class. In the training data, these columns contain values 0 and 1 to indicate the actual class. Besides, we select the conversion from number integer, since our columns are already one hot encoded and contain values of type integer. Here we also need to select the loss function. We can choose between a standard loss function and our own custom loss function. Since we solve a multinomial classification problem, we select the categorical cross-entropy. Finally, in the tab Options, we can define our training parameters. We train 100 epochs, set the training batch size to 5, use the shuffling option, and as an optimizer, we use Adam with the default settings for the learning rate. Additionally, you can select the GPU in the tab Advanced Options and select whether the Python executable comes from KNIME Preferences or from Conda Environment Propagation node in the tab Executable Selection. Let's now execute the node. The node provides the interactive learning monitor view, where you can observe how the accuracy and loss are changing for the training and validation data during the network training. You can observe the metrics in the line charts, in the view on the right side, or in the Keras log output. If you see that the performance is satisfactory, you can stop training by clicking the Stop Learning button. Now that we have the network trained, let's make the predictions for the test data with the Keras network executor node. In the configuration of this node, we set the input batch size equal to the size of the training batch, select the input features, and select the conversion from number double. Besides, we click the Add Output button and select the output layer. In our case, it is the second dense layer with the softmax activation. The output should be converted to number double, since we want to predict the probability for each class. You can see that the node produces three new columns, which contain the predicted probability of each class. In order to get the final prediction, we select the class with the highest probability with the rule engine node. Then, we evaluate the classification model as usual with the scorer node. The Keras network writer node saves the network for deployment. In this video, we demonstrated how to prepare the data for neural network training, as well as build, train, evaluate, and save a simple feed-forward neural network in KNIME Analytics platform.